Как важно вот искать волю Божию.
It is important to be looking for God's will, at least if we're serious about finding it.
В общем-то, в большинстве своем этой воли Божией.
In most cases, what we really are looking for is God's confirmation of our own will. Instead of wondering what God wants us to do, we want His approval of our decisions. We need that to gain confidence that our plans and our wishes are righteous. We want that approval at any cost. Things that fall out of the scope of our priorities usually pass us unnoticed. We could hardly accept these things, even if we wanted to. Somehow they're simply off our radar. We're so convinced that we know what's best for us, that if someone tells us that we're doing something wrong, we simply do not listen.
Мы не ищем действительно воли Божией, а мы настаиваем на своем.
Very often we end up choosing to have it our own way and make mistakes. This sinful scheme proves wrong year after year.
Греховный механизм, когда мы чего-то захотим, когда мы какие-то у нас состояния, чувства такие,
but we tend to advocate it.
Вот нам надо так. И даже больше того, когда нам кто-то говорит, так нельзя, и так вы больше делать не будете,
even to the point of becoming so much driven by our desires, that we become deeply hurt when somebody tries to stop us. What do you mean, you're wrong, we say. God bless that. Here at the convent, we like to say, this is Father Andre's blessing. In most cases, I have no idea what these blessings are. In reality, people come to me with ready strategies, looking as if they know exactly what to do and eager to do it. There is nothing left for me to say but go ahead. Hardly does anyone ever come to me and say, what should I do? How do I live my life now? Everybody has a plan already, you see. All roles outlined, all ducks in a row. The only thing missing is a stamp and a signature. It looks too much like we have already considered all odds and need no advice from anyone, not even God. We are expecting nothing less than God doing what we want. This cannot be right. The interesting thing is that we are still calling this looking for God's will. As a result, our good intentions take us anywhere but where we want to be.
Нужно быть готовым принять волю Божию.
I think that to avoid this happening, we have to prepare ourselves so that we are ready to accept God's will. Doing so involves undergoing many changes, because evil doesn't sit still. Far from it, sin is actively pushing us in its direction, trying to make us think that there is no other way. I'm in a situation right now, for example, where I have to make a decision. Yesterday I was 100% sure that I knew what decision was right. Today I heard an opinion that differs from mine, and it's not that I'm hesitant, but I consent that God may be speaking through that person as well. Later in the day, I heard yet another opinion. I still have my own understanding, but is my understanding the cornerstone? I guess I am hesitant after all, which is good and bad. The reason I'm hesitating is because I see my own sinfulness. My sinful side cannot be the truth, so I want God to bring me to reason. I want Him to make me conductor of His will. I think that we all want that, unless we are our own enemies, which we obviously aren't. I think that we all root for ourselves. It turns out that if we want to accept God's will, we need to go through capital repairs inside. Everything needs to be rebuilt. But what if for years I have been upbringing my old man? What if my own will has got a strong hold of me and does not want to let go? We have to resist the old man, although he will be trying to convince us that following him is the only way.
Вот Христос говорит одно, но когда Он говорил и кому Он говорил,
He will be telling us that Christ lived a long time ago, and that everything is different now. If we listen, we will find ourselves arguing with God before we know it. We are not ready for heaven yet, it appears. We wouldn't be stuck here on earth if we were. Christ would have taken us to His kingdom and spared us the suffering. But we still have to learn something, to do the correction work. We have to change something in our lives. This is why we are given time. The question is, what we are going to do with this time? How are we going to use it? How can we avoid making mistakes, or at least make fewer of them? How do we use our effort wisely, so that we do not harm ourselves and our neighbor? How do we accept God's will when it seems unbearable?